You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show. We talk all about what's new in Azure AI Foundry, April 2025 edition. Make sure you tune in. Hello, and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're talking all about what's new in Azure AI Foundry, April 2025 edition. With my friend Steve Sweetman. Again, today we're diving into something that I think every developer needs to hear about, how to keep your AI projects nimble when the ground is shifting this fast. There's a lot of stuff happening. We all know the pace of AI innovation is insane right now. It feels like there's a new model or tool dropping every single week. Azure AI Foundry is stepping up as a real GPS for teams trying to make smart decisions without burning time or budget. Joining me is Steve Sweetman, Partner Program Manager for Azure OpenAI, to walk us through the latest and greatest, not just what's new, but how developers can actually use this momentum to their advantage. Steve, how you doing, bud?
Thanks for having me, Seth. I can't believe this is my first time on AI Show.
I know, what a tragedy.
Excited. But you know what I'm also excited about?
Tell me.
Excited about how developers are going to navigate the AI landscape with so many new models, so many evaluation tools, ready-to-use services, and what they're going to do, how they're going to really innovate with that.
That's amazing. So let's start with Foundry itself. It's grown beyond just a catalog of models. It's becoming this full-on control center for managing your AI portfolio, evaluating models, and optimizing for cost. Steve, can you walk us through the biggest new capabilities lighting up in Foundry right now?
Yeah, I mean, a little bit like it's spring outside in the Northern Hemisphere right now. Things are blossoming. We have over 1,917, that's 1,917 models in the Azure AI Foundry catalog. But it's not just about the model set. It's about the way that you navigate and use that choice. So to help you, one of the new things we've introduced is the evaluation API in Azure OpenAI service, which lets developers automatically compare the quality, cost, and throughput of different models. That way, teams can quickly choose and test and quantify which model is actually going to help improve their applications, not just guess. Alongside that, we've also released the stored completions API. This allows developers to really easily capture the outputs of their model completions during the evaluation process, and then iteratively refine it, whether it's through prompt tuning or fine tuning. Together, these tools really help accelerate the time that it takes to be able to improve, deploy, iterate, and update your applications in production.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of not just like, let's just hope it works manually. I mean, you get real data fast on whether a model is better, cheaper, faster, or not even worth the swap, which is really cool. Okay, so speaking of models, it's been a crazy few weeks. OpenAI dropped GPT 4.1, a bunch of new audio models, and even new real-time previews with WebRTC support and smarter noise reduction. There's a ton of process. Can you walk us through the biggest model announcements and how developers should think about when to upgrade or explore or both?
Yeah. Without a doubt, April 2025 has been the biggest model launch month for OpenAI and Azure OpenAI. In fact, without giving too much away, we've had the fastest growing new models with 4.1.
Wow.
It's so popular. It's fast, it's cheaper, it's better quality than 4.0. It's simply stunning, and customers are loving it. But that's not all. We also have the new audio models with transcription and speech recognition, high quality capabilities that are bringing new modalities to life. And talking about new modalities, we all saw that viral ChatGPT image creation features. Now that's available in an API. So developers can incorporate that into their applications too with GPT Image 1. And of course, we've got the real-time previews that now support WebRTC. This makes it scale far better than in the past, bringing real-time voice to your applications. And the best part is all of these models are available in Azure AI Foundry the same day that OpenAI announces them. They're backwards compatible, which means they can be deployed either through Portal with a few lines of code and simply extend the functionality of your existing application. And you can really quickly test it in the playground, evaluate it, and update your app using those tools we talked about just before.
And that's pretty amazing because, I mean, the cool thing about this is that I love the idea of backwards compatibility, because just because something new drops doesn't mean you need to upgrade right away. But being able to know it's fast and worth it is also critical. Okay, now OpenAI gets a lot of headlines, but what's exciting to me is how many other players there are leveling up to. There's Meta, Mistral, Cohere, DeepSeek. It feels like Foundry is building an ecosystem where you can mix and match the best tool for each part of your app. Can you break down some of the most exciting new arrivals?
Yeah, and without a doubt, we aim to be the best platform in which you can use the best models in the industry. And you're right, it's not just about Azure OpenAI and OpenAI. Llama 4, incredible models that just arrived. You've got Scout, which is made like it sounds to go out there and analyze those millions of documents, for example, that you might have sitting in your SharePoint library and discover the answer to those critical questions that you need. And then there's Maverick, which is really focused on understanding multimodality, images and text with support for over 12 different languages, Seth. And then there's OCR. Like, we've all got those filing cabinets full of papers and documents. So how do you use AI with that? Mistral's next generation optical character recognition model is hugely popular. Amazing quality to extract images, equations, tables, and scan text from documents. But it doesn't stop there. Cohere's latest Command R and embedding 4 models are perfect for extracting those insights from massive data sets like financial reports or market research. And then, hey, we can't miss the DeepSeek R1 that really shook up the industry at the end of last year. And we've got a new variant of our own. Microsoft released MAI DeepSeek R1, which outperforms the original model when it comes to blocking harmful or restricted content.
And that's amazing, because first you named off the OpenAI stuff, but then there's a lot of other vendors that are doing some amazing stuff, which you just talked about. It's like having a Swiss Army knife. You've got specialized tools for different tasks, and it's not a one model fits all type of situation anymore, which is awesome. Okay, so shifting gears a little, not every dev team can build everything from scratch. Azure AI services like Agent Service and AI Search are all about giving teams shortcuts to production, safety, and at scale. What's new on the services front this month?
There's a lot of goodness there too, Seth. And I'm going to tell you a little secret. My favorite AI service, can I say that on the show?
Yeah,
AI service is Azure AI Content Understanding.
Oh.
And I'm really excited because there's a new 3-part video series that covers how to build a RAG application over, get this, your video data sets. So now you can build this amazing call, understand, and extraction capabilities over video. But it doesn't just stop there.
That's cool.
There's the Azure AI agent service too. It makes it easier to build and deploy agents that bring together multiple tools from across your application and making hundreds of lines of codes far more simple, just like Fujitsu and NTT Data did when they prioritize and sped up their sales process with an agent. Now, all of this has to be powered with Azure AI Search, right? Which continues to scale to large scale retrieval use cases. And we've added new portal and SDK features that lets you upgrade the service and adjust pricing on the fly. No longer do you have to create a new deployment for a new pricing tier. One standout customer example, let me just share this with you, is UBS's legal AI assistant. It uses AI Search to comb through, get this, 26 million documents across multiple languages to support legal research. That's a real game changer, Seth.
Yeah, I mean, it really is. Having understanding of like the mass of information that's in any application is absolutely amazing. And if you're building RAG apps, for example, or anything retrieval heavy, search is the not so secret weapon a lot of teams are leaning on now. Okay, so before we wrap, real talk, I love hearing about real world wins, because theory is nice, but execution is everything. What do you got for us?
Yeah, so we started this talking about navigating your way with a GPS. And one of the places we all navigate to regularly, at least I do, is our homes. And that's where CoStar.com comes in. So CoStar Group is the developer and owner of many applications like homes.com and apartments.com that lets you find your next house. And we know that that's a task that many of us do on the go. which means we need new, rich ways to interact. And so I love seeing what customers like CoStar are doing by incorporating audio into their applications to be able to communicate and understand information about what is that next house? What are the details? What's it going for? What are the opportunities for me? And now consumers can interact directly with their applications using real-time audio. And CoStar Group was able to do this really quickly because they had a common AI foundation, meaning they were already building with AI tools and they could plug in modality from Azure AI Foundry to really innovate the experience.
I mean, this is cool because it's not just about building faster, it's about delivering better experiences with AI at global scale, which is not the dream for a lot of, which is a huge dream for dev teams out there. I love delivering good experiences. All right, so big takeaways from today, the pace of AI isn't slowing down. If anything, it's accelerating, right?
It is definitely accelerating. And with that acceleration, it's easy to get lost. Where do I go? Where do I start? What do I choose? And that's where Azure AI Foundry is turning into the GPS for every developer. A way to navigate the complexity, move fast when it matters, and make smart, confident decisions.
Awesome. And so for people to learn more about this, I put the in the lower thirds there. You can go to azureai.azure.com. But I understand that there's a blog too. Is that right?
Yeah, there is a blog. Hopefully you've got the link for that too, that highlights everything we talked about and more with some amazing video case studies as well.
Awesome. Well, thanks again, Steve, for joining in. And to our viewers, stay tuned, subscribe, and let's build the future of AI together. Thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about what's new in Azure AI Foundry, April 2025 edition. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.